Everyone, okay, I am back and I have covered everything. Or rather, I covered this whole tin and I just cut bits and pieces and made sure that I covered all the edges all the way around. This is a thin lace, so you could see the foil there, or the tin there, or the pan there, whatever you want to call it. But it's all done, I think, for the most part. And I have all my scraps here. I pulled them out because that's what helps me to figure out what scrap to use next. So now that I have it all covered, I think I want to put a border. And I was looking through here for a long lace, and yeah, this is it. And I think I found this one that was coffee dyed, and I measured it, and it looks like it'll go all the way around. So what I'm going to do is just, I think I want to add this all the way around the top, and then I want to put something on top of it. So I kind of want to get it close to the edge. And I'm just going to start doing that now. Later on, I will cut out little flowers from the laces. You know, like these kind of little flowers and stuff. I have a bunch here that I cut from laces, and I might scatter them around in certain places, and that should be my final thing. And I'm just gonna start by adding the laces here, kind of on the edge, like that. Let me move this out of the way. Is a little flat edge here that I could maybe put bling or something. I'm not sure yet. Ribbons or flowers. I mean, or maybe I'll collage more scraps. I'm really not sure where I'm gonna go. Oops. But I do know I want this little edge there. And I thought about putting on some music, but I remembered every time I have music on in the background, sometimes I get YouTube mad at me because, you know, the copyright thing. So it's just gonna be quiet. I'm just putting a little tiny bit of glue . These are like getting in my way here. I hope you can see. that's going to look pretty. Finishing off the edge there. I'm just putting a really thin layer of glue there. Just brought my doggies in. It's a little bit cold out there. It's like 60. It's not really cold, but they like to be inside. They have this, our spare bedroom is their bedroom, little spoiled babies. So I hear one of them snoring, which is Lana. She's our, we have two boxers and a Jack Russell, and Lana and Luke are the boxers, and their sister and brother. And Lucy is the Jack Russell. And, Lana is the barker, and she is the one that snores. So if she gets loud enough, I can hear her snoring, but I don't know if it'll come out on the camera. If she gets loud enough, you'll know that that's Lana snoring. And I'm coming to the edge here. I'm so glad I had enough of this one. I almost thought I didn't have a long enough piece that was coffee dyed that I could use. So that was fast. Okay, that looks good. Because it's on the edge, I don't really want it facing down. And, oh, I just thought about, what if it doesn't fit in the box? Let me grab the box. And see if it's going to fit in there now that I put the... the edging and all this lace. Little bit snug, but it is gonna fit. Oh, that's good. I'm just gonna pull the edging up. Isn't that funny? It wants to go inside. Okay, well, at least I know it fits. Very, very nice. Okay, there we go. And I'll fix it better later, but look at how cutesy. That looks really nice. And then maybe I'll put something in the center here, but I want the goodies to show through, so I like that. It's very, very nice. And I don't know if I want to put something maybe on the inside, but I don't know what. What can I put on the inside? Okay, well, I'm gonna lift it here and move this since I know it fits and it's all good. I really want to add something here. Maybe I can do some fuzzy. Let me look at what kind of fuzzy. I have my fuzzy behind me. Probably should have did this before. Well, here we go. This is maybe some white or some of this. We'll look and see, or maybe both. Oh, these are from Gail. Oh, that's right. Wow, that's a whole big piece. And this one too. These are big pieces. Okay, let me see. That might look pretty just like that. I can unravel. Yep, I sure can. Okay, so I have that piece. Let me see if I can pull another piece. This was a scarf or something, I think. And I think that'll be long enough, so I'm gonna just snip it there. Thank you, Gail. This was some fuzzy that she gave me a while back. And if I do it facing inward, I don't know, on top, this way? I think it looks better that way, facing outward. Okay, so let's start with the little piece here. And let's do this. And I'm just putting little tiny bits. And you know me, I love layers, so layers, layers, layers. Yep, I think that's gonna look pretty. pretty. And once I get this covered, I also finished binding my friend Judy's two books. So I will give you a little peek at that, because I'm probably going to send them in the next day or two. And I already did send her a picture of the binding, and I let her know that they're done. And kind of got her approval that she was happy. So she was happy. And she did want me to bind the book in the same manner that I did the my first Gypsy book, which was, I call it, I don't know if it's got a particular name, but it's just how I decided to bind that book. I call it a corset type of binding, corset stitch, because when I was done, it looked like a corset tied up, so. That's what I did to one of them. And then the other one, I suggested that we could, or that I could, bind it in a different manner using little loops. And she agreed, one with the corset stitch and the other with little loops. And I think it came out good. I think it came out nice. I'm happy with the way they came out, and she's happy, so. I'm working on several, I don't even know how many, other projects. As I said, I'm always working on several different things at the same time because I get bored with one project after a while when I work on it for a little bit. And I need to be stimulated again with something new and different. So I either start something new or I'll go back to something else that I've already started and I'm still working on. Okay, I'm just right to the end here. And that's what keeps my brain fresh with ideas. Because when I start doing something else, it always triggers another idea, something new. Let me get rid of this fuzzies here. And it just keeps my creative muse happy. Let's say that. Okay. So we've done that. Let me put all the fuzzy back. I think I like that. Very pretty. Okay, and now I think what I want to do is, I don't really like all this silver popping up so much. I like it more covered. So I'm just going to try to figure out what else I can with the scraps. I have stuff like this, but make it too thick. I want it to be more flat, layered but flat. So that might be nice right there. And I don't really like corners or points, so I try to make the lace more round on the edges. And that fits perfectly there. Look at that. Because it won't cover this. This, it just kind of worked out that way. So let's do that. Just start at one end and then just go underneath. And try to put glue on an area where it's going to conceal, like all the stitches. Put some in here, and I'm just using very little bit. That's good. It's really nice. That looks good. I want something this way. Okay, so this one's nice. No. What's the darker one? Oh, I like that. I'm just going to cut around the motif here. Get rid of that corner. Okay. Right there. And I'm just putting glue on those edges so they don't come up. Just tiny little bit of glue. Not enough that it's gonna seep through. And now see this one. I just need a little bit. And actually, maybe I'll cut that little bit there. Oh, it's coming together really nice. And the reason why I'm doing this is because I want to cover up those, mostly all those raw edges. See, like right here, I kind of cut around, but I don't know if I like that. And especially right here, that's a raw edge. And look, see, I have a little bit there that needs to be cut. So I'm going to try to find... Let me get this. I'm going to try to find some things that I can use to cover those edges, like maybe these. Now, and that, see that raw, these raw edges right here? That's what I'm going to try to cover up. And then I need something, where was that? Right here. I need something right there, and I need something here. So it's going to cover right there. Lots and lots of glue strings everywhere, but I'll just hit all that with the heat gun and they will, all the spider webs will go away. See, because this is cut jagged, it just adds to the, style of everything just being pieced together. Okay, now I need something right there. So maybe one of these. That's too big. Yeah, I have little ones here. Oh, I like that one. Yep, I like that. Very nice. to be tacked down just a little bit. Okay, I'm really liking that. Now I want something here because I don't really like this area here. But I'm not going to use this, I don't think. No, it looks funny. So let's throw those to the side and let's see if I can't find. We need something long and kind of flowing there. Kind of like a swirl, maybe. I'm not sure about this one, but let's cut it and see what it looks like. And then we'll have this one to deal with. Oh, look at that. Maybe this right here. Okay, let's try that. Just gonna cut it right there.